I've traveled to Forest Hills. It's a suburb in New York where the US Open used to be played. This is where Althea Gibson, Arthur Ashe, and Billie Jean King each won Grand Slam titles. There hadn't been a professional match played here for a long time, and a few years ago there was even talk about tearing down this stadium. But as I found out, there's a new push to have pro tennis back on this court. Pro tennis returned to Forest Hills for the first time in nearly a decade. This summer, Caroline Wozniacki, Andy Roddick, and Christina McHale competed at the former home of the US Open.
When I found out that I was drafted to be on this team, I was super pumped, and being here with so much history and knowing that this is where the US Open used to be, and US Open is my favorite tournament, so it's just a really special place to be.
McHale played for the New York Empire. It's all part of World Team Tennis, where men and women compete together and scores are combined. Billie Jean King co-founded the professional league in 1974. This summer, she decided to base her newest team at Forest Hills, the site where she won 4 US Open titles.
It was such a wonderful stadium, and I remember in 1974, also when I won, and looking up with absolutely standing room only, people on the grass, and just thinking what a lucky kid I am to be out here and to be at finally winning the US Open, one of my big dreams as a child.
I remember just this vast area of lawn between the clubhouse and the Horseshoe Stadium. They were all grass courts, and you could touch the players if you're a fan. This little fence that would separate the fans from the players, so you can get up close and personal to the players.
I felt like even if you were in the top row of the stands here, you felt like you were right on top of the match. It was the ideal size for a major tennis stadium.
Tennis historian Steve Flink remembers when America's biggest tennis tournament moved from Forest Hills to nearby Flushing Meadows.
I think there was a sense of sadness among a lot of the longtime spectators who were sort of wedded to being at Forest Hills, where they'd seen the tournament played going back to the 20s, and they'd seen it explode during the Open era in 68, and they'd seen it move from the grass courts to a nice 3-year stretch on the clay from 75 through 77, and then leave here to go to hard courts at Flushing Meadows, to leave an elegant private club setting for a public park facility. For some people, they weren't ready to embrace that, but I believe that the USTA leaders who brought that change about were smart because they were gazing into the future.
While the US Open flourished at Flushing Meadows, the horseshoe-shaped stadium at Forest Hills sat vacant. This summer, Billie Jean King felt there was a market for tennis in the stadium again. That's when she hired Patrick McEnroe to help bring the sport back to Forest Hills.
It sort of was sad over the years that the actual city of New York actually condemned the stadium. It had gone into such disrepair over the years. And a couple of years ago, a team got together of investors and they decided to put on these concerts. You see this stage here, when they're not set up for a tennis tournament, they do concerts. So that was sort of the impetus to get the club and to get team tennis back into the mix to say, okay, we can use the stadium. Wouldn't this be a perfect place for team tennis?
The former pro and Long Island native agreed to coach the New York Empire.
You know, when Billie Jean King herself called me early this year and said, you know, we're thinking about bringing a team back to New York and we want to do it at Forest Hills, I said, sign me up. This was a great opportunity for me. You know, the men and women playing together, I think, is a great message that we can continue to send in tennis. We've only won a couple of matches, but we've had some hardcore fans come out and they seem to really get behind the team, so I'm hoping for bigger and better for 2017.
Plans are already in the works to bring the New York Empire back to Forest Hills next season. Tennis fans hope it's the start of more good news for the tennis stadium that's cheated death by demolition more than once.
There we go. Oh, baby!
You still got it, baby.
See that?
You still got it. Still got it. Great to see you. Thank you. It's not quite like the grass that you wanted, but
you
pretty
go.
Good.